This morning I want to talk about a couple different things. Right off the bat, I want to talk about a place that I'm always pushing people to go to, which is Iceland, which is so beautiful and amazing with all these natural wonders to explore. And for me, on my bucket list, it's always on my list to go check out one of the volcanoes when they blow there. This is the one from 2 years ago. I'd like to see it just, I think it's fascinating, either there or Hawaii or Central America, anywhere. But the problem is right now, the volcano that's going to blow is pretty concerning based on where this is happening. A map of Iceland, the capital Reykjavik's over here, right down on this peninsula, is a lot of seismic activity right now. Dozens and dozens of earthquakes happening there. The question is the volcano going to blow on land or just off the coast? What's down there? Well, quite a bit. In fact, Iceland's most famous attraction, the Blue Lagoon, is down there. It's evacuated right now. It's not my favorite place in the whole country, but it is definitely the most popular for tourists, and it's closed down for the foreseeable future, along with the town that's down there, which is home to one of the most amazing Airbnb I've ever stayed in my life. This is an old water tower, which they've converted into a three-story home. And it's part of this fishing village that's down on the coast of Iceland, which is totally evacuated right now. So major concerns over where this volcano is going to blow in the coming days. I actually have friends there, heading there in a couple days to go check out the Northern Lights and the ice caves. No flight disruptions just yet, but we're going to be watching that seismic activity under Iceland in the next coming days and see what happens with that volcano. Okay, let's talk about travel deals here domestically, because right now I'm going to put in my final pitch for going to New York City for the Christmas season, because it's so beautiful. Look at the price drop. Here we have, this is the round trip price now from Phoenix to New York City on American or Delta Airlines. In fact, United just added to this list this morning, $228. This is the nonstop. United will get you to Newark. American and Delta will fly to JFK. This is for a long weekend, December 8th through 12th. Amazing flight prices, but you will find hotel prices in New York City right now are crazy, so it might be a good time of year to check with family and friends in Long Island or New Jersey or on the outskirts of the city to see if you can crash there for a couple days so you can take advantage of that price deal. Okay, this is the viewer question I want to answer. A woman emailed in, said she had Thanksgiving week off. Family and friends weren't doing anything here, wondering if I had any last-minute travel deals for Thanksgiving. My immediate answer was no, there are no last-minute travel deals for a holiday, but then I remembered the rest of the world doesn't celebrate Thanksgiving. So look at what I found. This is Sunday to Sunday. Next week, November 19th through 26th, here's where you can go. Milan, $600 on American Airlines. Hamburg, Germany, $590. Amazing train system there. You could take the train all over the place. $590 round trip from Phoenix. Zurich, Switzerland, $560 next week. Round trip, that's the base fare. If you want to bring luggage or upgrade your seats, it goes up from there, but $560 is a great fare. Now, the weather is not guaranteed to be fantastic in those places in November, but look at this. Barcelona, southern Spain, $540 round trip on American Airlines next week. Mallorca, an island in the Mediterranean, $570 next week. That's probably the lowest I've ever seen. And Nice, France, southern coast of France on the Mediterranean, November 19th through 26th. American and British Airways, $545. Amazing deals. So back here stateside, I wanted to put in a pitch for Maui right now. I posted this yesterday on social media because I don't know how long this deal is going to last. They're allowing visitors back in Maui, in fact, welcoming them right now to help boost tourism numbers, as long as you're respectful and stay away from the areas hurt by the wildfire. This is one example, December 1st through 6th, under $300 on American or United. And you'll find these deals under $300 round trip from Phoenix right now through December into January, even into February, just not the holiday weeks. So check it out if you want to get to the Hawaiian Islands for an amazing deal, because I've rarely seen it under $300 this year. Phoenix to Maui under $300, again, December, January, and February, minus the holiday weeks. Now, I posted this on social media yesterday, you guys, because I don't know how long that deal's going to last. Yeah. It could last till the end of the day. It could last the rest of the week. But if you want to head to Hawaii, that's an amazing deal. It's not going to get better than that.
And I think a lot of people are wondering, you know, they want to be respectful, but also want to help in terms of the tourism money. So it's kind of good to know that's where they stand on the island.
Much of the island was untouched by the fire. You know, they've got hotels all over the place. The road to Hana is an amazing place to visit as well. Untouched, thankfully, by that wildfire. They do need tourists back as a boost to the economy.
Jared, thank you. And I will say, I do have Thanksgiving week off, but I wasn't the one that emailed you. But I want to go to Nice and Mallorca.
Oh, I've never seen it I've never seen it for that low of a price. And the weather's great this time of year.
Okay.
So think about
it. We'll check it out.
You've convinced us.
Okay. All right, see you next time.
Thanks, Jared.